Hey, DJ Mikey Mike in Direct Sound, and we are doing a quick vlog today. I hope, you know how I am, I try to help people out, and technology's moving forward, I'm moving forward, and I bought myself a Windows 8 computer. A super fast Windows 8 computer, i7 with 16 gigs of RAM, thing is smoking fast, and I was trying to run it with my Pioneer 400 CDJ 400s, having issues, a lot of issues, with Virtual DJ. Virtual DJ seemed to work fine until I turned on my 400s, and then wouldn't work. So I had the right, I had the drivers downloaded right, and before I even started using the software, I had Ableton loaded, and I had Pro Tools there was a whole bunch of stuff that I tried to load. So what I did, after having all these issues from my last video, I wiped out my computer, brand new computer, I started back up from scratch, in case I screwed up something. So, I went back to the Pioneer website, I downloaded the newest driver for the CDJ 400s, and I downloaded the newest firmware. So I updated my firmware on my 400s. That seemed to help a lot. More. Help better. It was better. Also, since then, I went and bought a USB 3 hub. So it's going to take away some of my wiring issues, which was cool. So now I can actually get it back to where I need it to go. So it looks pretty clean now. So it's still intermittent. And I'll tell you what the kind of the magic bullet is, okay, for me. The CD players seem to have a driver issue and they fall off the USB bus and give me errors all the time, depending on how I start it up. Okay, so basically, if I leave the USB connected to the computer and I restart my computer, it doesn't see it. But after this computer starts up fully and then I plug my USBs in or turn the CD drives on, then it seems to work better or recognize it better. If I don't do that, it gives me an error. Not enough channel error, and it's only seeing one CD player or the other. Now, first I was having MIDI issues, and it was going to the wrong channels and a bunch of other things, and it's basically just a driver issue. So I'm getting it to work more consistently now. It doesn't work 100% all the time, but I think I'm getting the hang of getting it to work right. So that's a good thing. Just more of a sequence of startup. So that's good. That's good. One other good thing is the CDJ and Virtual DJ with his i7 computer really freaking works great. It's awesome. I like it. My hard drive, I have a USB 3 hard drive. Now with the USB 3 bus going on, it's smoking fast. There's no delays. It loads songs quickly. Haven't tried video yet because I don't have any video loaded on this hard drive, but it seems to be working great. So that's awesome. So I'll show you a little bit about the speed. The Pioneers with the new firmware upgrade seems to be really responsive. I'll just play a little track here. I can actually do some triples and a couple other little mixing techniques, which I couldn't do before because everything lagged and had a lot of problems, but seems to be working great. So listen, it's cool and it looks better. So take a look. All right, so what we're gonna do is I'm gonna play this little Michael Jackson track and I'm gonna just set my players to the same. And then I'm going to backtrack this just a little bit and then just do a little triple in. You'll see how responsive Virtual DJ is being. You know, I'm not the greatest mixer in the world. You know, I can mix, but we'll see what happens with. And this is brand new to me with being able to mix with my 400. So I'm used to turntables. So anyway, here we go. So we'll backtrack this about a quarter of a turn. I'll get it playing. We'll back this track about a quarter of a turn. And then we're going to be able to triple a little bit. Here we go. So it's pretty responsive, it seems like it's doing okay. So you can see it's pretty responsive, it's doing okay, not too bad. The scratch isn't too bad. It's really quick, no latency, it's awesome, I like it. So no latency, it's doing really well. Virtual DJ, Windows 8, Pioneer CDJ 400s. I haven't integrated the 5000 mixer yet in case I want to do CDs and Virtual DJ at the same time. Not controlled, but at least native or whatever inside the player. That's another animal, but that's cool. So it's DJ Mikey Mike, Seems like I have it working a little bit. Okay, so it's better than it was. Big problem was my hub. Other big problem was firmware update. And then I made sure I had the most current Pioneer driver. And the MIDI portion works. Sometimes it goes through the wrong channel. Sometimes it goes doesn't recognize CD players. Seems like it's a plug-in type issue, like a sequence. So try that, see if it works for you. Seems to be working for me. Every time I would restart my computer, it wouldn't see it. Unplug the CD players, plug them back in or turn them on and off, and it seems to start recognizing them and quit keeping them from falling off the USB bus. So, DJ Mikey Mike, peace!